body. What shall we do? Sinjan.
What shall we do?
In sub-Saharan Africa, smallholder farmers derive their primary source of income from their only real asset, small plots of land. These smallholder farmers make up about 70% of Africa's population. In Kenya alone, there are more than 20 million people dependent upon the economic productivity of the small farms to feed, clothe, house, and educate themselves and their families. Since independence, most African countries have failed to effectively reach these rural communities with sustainable development. For decades, these farmers have been struggling to meet their basic needs, but they remain trapped in a cycle of poverty due to low productivity and poor financial returns on farm activities. Rich African farmland has unlimited agricultural potential. Yet, the African smallholder is still laboring for very little return and remains locked in this cycle of poverty. Let's take a closer look at a farmer living in Kenya named Bernard. Bernard takes his produce to the local market 2 to 3 times every week using an ox cart. A slow and tiresome process that takes up hours of his day traveling between his home and the closest produce market. Without alternative buyers, his produce will perish before he gets another chance to sell. Once he actually reaches the market, he must contend with brokers and traders vying for his produce, and he usually walks away feeling cheated. Why? Working by himself, Bernard faces a disadvantageous situation in his local market, not knowing current prices and not having other marketing options. Up in the highlands around Mount Kenya, Mary is a tea farmer living at the poverty line. Her family has been growing tea for decades, but she is interested in generating more income. Mary has heard of a new cash crop called passion fruit that would do well on her highland farm. But Mary is unable to invest in this lucrative crop due to lack of investment capital. These same challenges continue to prevail: lack of resources, technical know-how, knowledge of markets, and market pricing. For these farmers, even with the proper financial resources, selling into the best markets would be difficult. The larger markets of Nairobi and Karatina are intimidating for these individual farmers. Mary is frustrated by her lack of options when it comes to selling the produce grown on her small plot of land. Pride Africa, a Nairobi-based NGO, has been developing commercially sustainable microfinance institutions in East and Central Africa for the past 15 years, focusing on the urban poor. Beginning in 2003, Pride Africa launched DrumNet to address the challenges faced by rural smallholder farmers. DrumNet is being developed as a commercial network of farmer support centers delivering a targeted set of marketing, financial, and information services to assist them in productively operating their farms. The vision of DrumNet is a profitable, market-based, private sector organization run by and for its members. First, DrumNet works with community-based organizations to form small marketing groups. Then DrumNet coordinates and facilitates the collection of their produce so that these farmers can compete with larger growers and negotiate better prices. Bernard and his fellow farmers have organized themselves into a French bean marketing group. DrumNet has taught Bernard's group the proper way to grade and package French beans in preparation for the export market. DrumNet has negotiated contractual arrangements with large-scale French bean buyers and exporters. These buyers range from the biggest exporters of horticultural produce to local processors of fruits and vegetables to the small-scale domestic buyers of lower quality produce. Through contractual arrangements with transporters, Bernard no longer needs his ox cart. DrumNet facilitates the pickup and delivery of produce at pre-arranged times and locations. With the support of DrumNet Marketing Services, Bernard and his group can access the best markets and the best prices.
DrumNet ni matuteidetia muno muno. Tondu mimerere matuire tutubande, mamiadhire thoko siya kwendia. Dhiku isini ndira wanda babycon, gawanda misiri, itunguru, nyanya.
The investment in seeds, fertilizers, agrochemicals, equipment, and labor required to successfully grow high-value crops is beyond the means of most smallholder farmers. DrumNet has implemented a targeted, cashless credit product in partnership with local banking institutions. To qualify for the program, farmers must be in good standing with DrumNet and have contributed to a savings account over a period of time. The credit is delivered to the farmer through a network of local agro-supply vendors. DrumNet members are able to access the farm products they need using their DrumNet transaction card. The entire transaction takes place with no exchange of cash, and the merchant receives electronic payment from DrumNet soon after the transaction is completed.